Afternoon. Well, as you can see, I'm in the middle of a pool game on Facebook. Just going to finish this game before we move on to what I've got planned. It's probably one of the better games on Facebook. There's quite a selection of various games. You can play snooker, blackball pool, or European pool. Eight ball and nine ball. I think they're the only options there is. Nuts, shot myself in the foot. Can I get that one? I'm trying to be clever. Not going to work, is it? Oh, yes, it is. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Got the ball to land on the wrong side of this one. I've got to have to hit a yellow ball and play it safe. So I had no shots on. I've already beaten this guy once because he accidentally dropped the black. Halfway through a game, so I gave him a rematch. I was playing someone last night, that was 8-ball pool we were playing, and I beat him 7 times out of 7 games, and it was him that kept choosing the rematch. He kept wanting a rematch, and I beat him 7 times out of 7 games. Talk about glutton for punishment. You're not going to get it in that pocket. Well, that's one less for me to drop down the pot. I think my easiest option is going to be that one, but it's going to go straight into that bloody... I wonder if I can get a bit of backspin on it. Probably not, that never works with me. No. But I've left him open to drop it into that middle pocket. Oh, what about another shot? Oh yeah, I have. I didn't know that. Oh, I've got another shot. Can I drop this black? Let's go for the bottom pocket here. Line it up. Boing! I win! Sorry to do that to you, but I've got things to do. I'll come back to that later. Right, put the tripod legs up. Now, as you recall, in previous video, I was testing those little blue Ethernet hubs. And I was testing them on my bigger custom-built XP machine. And they didn't work, if you remember rightly. Well, as you can see, they do work on this machine. And if you remember me saying in the other video, that my custom-built XP machine I was using was... What's going on here? I keep hitting... I type in the word, I hit eBay, and that disappears. Why is it disappearing? What's going on here? Okay, so let's close Firefox, and I'll start again. Ethernet lights flashing all over the place, I bet. Ah, there we go, it's working now. See? I haven't tried the other one yet. Should we have a go at the other one, see if we can get it to work? Probably does, as this one does. I don't know what it is with my other XP computer, but it doesn't seem to like Ethernet. I don't know why, it just doesn't. one of the other reasons I upgraded. So I'll switch this to 7.5 volt. Plug in the universal adapter. Plug in Ethernet. We have an Ethernet light flashing. Let's see if we can go to eBay, shall we? Unable to connect. Ah, the main Ethernet lights have gone off. So there's no link. Could be my cable, actually. It is. There we go, we've got web now. I didn't push the Ethernet cable in far enough. Does it every time. Stupid hub. Continue, I don't want downloading that crap, I just want to use the interwebs. No, I don't want parental controls. I'm 31, I know what I'm doing. If I want to watch porn, I'll watch porn. Well, there we go. The interwebs is working on this one, and that proves that both these Ethernet hubs work. I still don't understand why. They're exactly the same model number, look. EN104, but the voltage is different on each. I don't know if that's going to come up on there, but that's 5 volt. No, it's too blurry. This one's a 5 volt, 800 milliamp. The other one, if I unplug now, is a 7.5 volt, 1 amp. I haven't really got much of a use for those, you know. I don't know what these are actually used for. Because I know you can link these all together. You just select the uplink like that, and I think you'd put... I'll have to look at the PDF manual again, but you know, I know that you'd have to link one end into the number 4. So I don't know if it's to like extend the Ethernet range, because I know they do say to use as short cables as possible. I must have put the camera on again, because I need to go to the bathroom. Typical. I've got a few things I want to just test out on this, to see if they work. Where is it? I was playing with it last night. There it is. A flexible keyboard. Seems like a peculiar item to throw out. I don't know what I'll do with it. If it works, might keep it, might toss it, I don't know. I'll not toss it. We'll plug it in, and we'll let it install, and I'll tap on a few rubbery keys, and we'll see if it works. Still installing. I think I need to sort my main cupboard out, and well, it appears to be working, it's typing things. Caps work. No, it doesn't. Not fun. And the caps key to work. But I'd assume the shift. Well, that's right, shift works, and that's about all I ever use anyway. I don't really use a caps key. Well, it appears to work anyway. That's good. I think, as I prefer using external keyboards with laptops, if I can, obviously, you know, if I'm sitting at a table, I'll prefer to use an external keyboard and mouse. And I think I'll keep hold of that for that reason, because it just rolls up. If I remember rightly, that was the whole point of these sorts of keyboards. You can just roll them up like that, and if you wanted to, and pack them into your laptop bag, or you could lay them flat in your laptop bag, whatever suits you. Right, well, I was just trying to remember what else I've got to do today. That's done. I need to clear this table, because I'm going to get that monitor in up here for this system down here, the Sony Vaio. Just going to look into those cards. I've got a hard drive I'm going to put into there. That's all got to be done. I've got a fan there to test. Yeah. Several items on eBay selling today. Blah 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 blah. I have to get some bubble wrap during the week to do these bike frames and wheel, because that's all got to be couriered. Alright, so what I'm going to do is stop the camera here and sort stuff out, ready to crack on, and I'll turn the camera back on in a bit. So, talk to you in a bit. Well, I'm back. I'm just shutting down the PC because I'm getting ready to chuck in a 500GB Western Digital hard drive, Western Digital Green. That was very kindly given to me by a good friend of mine. So that's going to go in the machine. Well, that's shut down. Obviously, you never do anything like that while the machine is live. And I think while I've got it open, I may give it a clean out as well. Oh, I see. The loose cable. Cable got caught there somewhere. Hang on. Yeah, it is the mouse cable. I'm on it. I'm sitting on it. Might give me a bit more slack. It's rather dusty on the top here, and I do try to keep my vents clean. Let's have a bit of light as well. I do believe I'll make dust this out. Ooh, it is looking rather dusty in there, isn't it? Maybe I should invest in some filters for this to keep it clean. Rag on from you, boy. Cloth. Oh, I guess I have. What's it like underneath in the floor vents? Especially for that power supply. Lay that down. Yeah, look. To clean. But really, apart from that, it's not too bad. So let's try to see what SATA cable I already used. I could have wanted to put a 320GB drive in here, but, well, along with the 500GB, but I don't really need anything like that yet, so I'll upgrade that as and when and if I need it. I'm going to have a sort out this cupboard later today. I'm going to empty everything from that and put these PCs in this top cupboard. And the reason for that is them boards are a lot more solid than these. And there's a lot of stuff up there that I usually need to get to, like the spare bulbs, keyboards, monitor, CD cases, etc. So I just figured I'd be better off probably putting most of that lot on one of these shelves down here. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm just thinking, I'll think of something. Yeah, and that bloody PC up there, the one I was using to test things with in the kitchen, has a weird Ethernet issue for some reason. I think it's due to the motherboard. Oh! Oh dear. Right. So, I now need to find an SATA cable. I've got my toy cars in here where they all fell off the shelf. Ooh, easier if I just tip the box out. Okay. That panel shouldn't be in there. Yes, park my ass on the edge of the bed and see what I can find. I've got some really, really short ones. I've got a pretty orange one. Could put a pretty orange one in there. A lot of these short ones I've got came from, like, old flat towers. I've got a grey one. So I've got two possibilities. The other hard drive's on a grey one, so I could just match them up with another grey one. I do have a long grey one somewhere, but I can't find it. Oh, there's a black one. Oh no. I think that might be the one I'm thinking of. Might be. I thought it was a lighter grey, but as I can't find a lighter grey one, that must be the one I'm thinking of. Unless, of course, I have got a light grey coloured one that isn't here. That might be somewhere else. All these panels are there. These panels don't go in here. Okay, so I'm going to take these ones through. Bring Henry through as well. Also, to note, you shouldn't really do things like this on a carpet, especially. I've never had an overheat issue with this, but that is probably due to the fact I do keep it relatively clean in here. Stay with me. No.
God, I turned it off at the wall.
I need electricity to run something electrical. That's better. Had a bit of a duh moment there. Right. Damage components. So, yeah, do not be tempted. Oh, hang on. I'm just gonna get my bag in the bottom here as well. There's a lot of gunk under there. Give it a clean. Serial ATA cable is exactly what I need. Go ahead and plug this into the board first, I think. Get down there. I've got no sort of cable tidying method in this, so it's like spaghetti junction. Should have room. Around there as well in a minute. I just want to get everything plugged in again. The keyboard went in that one. Not that it matters because it'll just set itself up again. That one. But this cover isn't on properly.
Yeah.
Give that back. Turn it on. Can we get this camera back on? Seems to be working so far. Let's tuck those power cables in. What's my battery like? Oh, we're getting low. Well, it's booting fine so far. Take my thumb screws off the chair so I can sit down. There's a fan in here with a rattle to it. Now is it the rear fan or is it... I do believe it is the rear fan that's got a rattle, that's right then. So it's just not the processor. Much of the dust out as possible. I'm gonna let it boot. This machine does take a bit to boot. And then we can hope that where's the mouse gone? It was over there. Hope that's what I'm recognise the hard drive. Why is there no audio? I pulled the audio cable out, have I? Oh, there we go. Delayed, that's all. Right. I've got to change the batteries in the camera in a minute. In fact, I'm going to do that now, so I'll be back in a minute. Okay, we're back, and it's installing device driver software, so that's a good sign. It's got to be for the hard drive, because that's the only thing I installed. Oh, no, it's doing it for the optical mouse. I don't know why, because it's working. I must have accidentally swapped the USB ports around on the back. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Just gonna let that finish booting. The hard drive light's still active, so it's still booting. Not sure what next job will be. I think to install the monitor onto there. Which means clearing all that crap off. If this hard drive recognises, I've got all these folders. Well, all the folders apart from these ones here, all these top ones have got to be transferred over, and there's some that I've got to go onto external drives as well. Which, if I'm going to be making extra storage and backing up files, I might as well do it properly. So, if anything does fail, oh. There it is, it's come up with the hard drive as well. And the USB keyboard. It's a Logitech. Is it? Oh yeah, it is. Yeah. Dumbass, I forgot what make my own keyboard was. Good, that's ready to use. I'm still doing things. It's probably going to take a lot longer to boot than normal because it's sorting all these out as well. But it's got... It's searching Windows Update. Aha! It's found the driver software for the mouse, which is done. So it's just the keyboard, and that'll be done. I've got some... All those folders there for different YouTube videos that I've still got to render up. Ah, good. We're done. That's an empty hard drive. Well, that's good, because I can just highlight all of that and just go, boof. Ah. It might take a while to swap it over, because there's going to be... It's still discovering items. 27 gigabytes to go over, 28 gigabytes. This is going to make a hell of a lot of space on this main drive. Over 100 gigabytes, just in those folders up the top there. Some Lego videos I've got to do. Oh, that one can actually go in the recycle bin, because I've uploaded that one. Can't remember if all those video clips are all for one video, or if I've done some single shot videos in there. I'm going to have to play them. So there's 132 gigabytes of data to go over in total. And according to that, that's going to take about an hour. So, I'm going to... nearly 100,000 items. Ouch. 98,418 items. Wow. Right. I'm going to leave the PC as it is for now. About 50 minutes remaining, but I suppose that will depend on the size of files when it comes across them. That is only an estimate after all, isn't it? I should have cut them, not copied them. That means I'm going to have to delete the whole lot now. I know that I've got a couple of folders on here which are rather large, such as my music folder up the top here, and I've got another folder full of music in here that can go across. I've got, you know, a load of videos and shit in here to go across. That'll free up several gigs as well. To be honest, I never bloody thought... Oh, Firefox was delayed. I never thought I'd actually need extra storage. Because I'm such a... Well, I consider myself to be a light user. I don't really download anything. A lot of what I've got downloaded... is actually on external drives like that one. I've got another one in the bedroom. So I've got one for videos and music and one for other files, and I think this one's for other files, yeah. That's the unlabeled one. I've got another one in the bedroom. So, as I've updated a lot of music and whatnot, I will transfer them to this external drive as well. Yeah, movies, cartoons, music, and other media and whatnot. The sticker's pulling off of that. Believe it or not, I've got these hard drive... Oh no, I didn't get these hard drive caddies for free. I've got these ones, cheap on eBay. I have got one under there, behind the salad cream bottles, that I did get for free from Freecycle. someone had put an advert on FreeCycle, advertising them for free. So I grabbed a couple. One was a Firewire one, which I didn't really have a use for, so I think I got a couple of quid for that on eBay, but I did keep that one. And I've got a 200 gigabyte IDE hard drive on that desk, just down by the monitor somewhere, which would be used as a storage drive. I'd need another one of these enclosures though. I didn't get the hard drive with them, it was just the enclosure. They are cheap, so you've got to be careful with them. They're not really designed to take hard drives in and out all the time. So you're better off just putting a hard drive in there and leaving it, like I do. I can't remember what the size of them are, but I put the biggest drives I had in, which I think was 160 gigabyte drives in these IDE drives. So that'll be a bit slow at transferring data across, but that doesn't matter. Well, there we go. Let's get Facebook up again. Minimise that. That's moving along nicely. Right, so I'm going to clear that table and move Henry out of the way. I can't put Henry in his normal spot over there because it's full of crap. I've got a compact keyboard down there. I'm going to take it into the kitchen and try it on the desktop through there. I've got to find the drivers I downloaded last night for this and see if this works. No real point in keeping it, but you never know. Still got a bag to go through. Oh, I've got all sorts of shit to do. That cupboard to sort out, so I'm just debating whether if I call it quits for this video and start another one, or if I just turn the camera off and tack something on at the end of this. We've got another 10 minutes. I'm going to call it quits for this video then and start a new one. So, thanks for watching. Thumbs up if you like it. Thumbs down if you don't. And, you know where to put your comments if you have any. Whatever's said and whatever you do with the like buttons, it's always a help to me. So, I'm not really fussed either way. So, again, thanks for watching and until next time. Talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.